news this noon. A Seminole County judge has just set bail for George Zimmerman. Good Thursday afternoon. I'm Jason Guy.
And I'm Sion Rhodes. And if the accused killer of Trayvon Martin wants to get out, it will cost him $1 million.
West 2's Bob Keeling joins us live from outside the courthouse in Sanford with the breaking details. Bob?
Well, and Jason and Sion, we've just gotten the order ourselves, and we're digesting it as we go along here. But the bottom line is that Judge Ken Lester has now set a $1 million bond for George Zimmerman. And really, in reading this language, it is what you might call a smackdown for George Zimmerman in many ways. If you look at a couple of quotes from this particular order setting bail, the judge said that he really scoffed at the notion that George Zimmerman was confused. He said that the defendant has flaunted the system, and he went on to say that the defendant is manipulating the system to his own benefit. Some very strong words from Judge Lester. It's not a done deal at all that he will be able to get out on this $1 million bond. For more instant analysis on today's ruling, Jeff Dean, veteran attorney, is joining us. And Jeff, when you look at some of the strong wording in here from Judge Ken Lester, what are some of the things that stick out with you?
Well, the main thing that sticks out for me is that Mr. Zimmerman has completely discredited himself with this judge as far as bond or bail goes. The judge is quite clear that the judge actually doesn't believe him now when it comes to the money, and he made a point to say that one of the things that Mr. Zimmerman clearly did was lie to his own attorney. That's really affected the way the judge is thinking about bail right now.
Okay, so number one, do you think it is or is not a done deal that George Zimmerman can even get out now that the bond is raised so high?
He has placed his attorneys in the worst position they can be in when it comes to his release. The problem is that they've got a lot of money, but not that much money when it comes to defending him. Now they have to decide whether they're going to use that money to get him out of jail, or they're going to leave him in jail and use that money to defend him. That's a real dilemma for them.
And Jeff, in looking at some of the wording in this order, we're also talking about George Zimmerman's credibility and the judge saying that this self-defense claim is the main issue. In looking at his possible attempt to try to go for immunity, asking it from this same judge, what does this ruling mean to that down the road?
It's really kind of a far-reaching ruling when you talk about some of the extra evidence that Mr. Zimmerman had in his favor before. One of the things the judge has done is he's changed his opinion about whether or not he should release George Zimmerman. And one of the things he based that on was his family, who he was relying on the first time to vouch for him. You saw Mr. Zimmerman's father in this last bond hearing. Mr. Zimmerman's father has some other evidence to say about whether Mr. Zimmerman could have committed a crime like this. Now they've all been discredited by this.
And one other thing that jumped out, Jeff, quickly, is that the judge appeared to say that he thought, at least initially, George Zimmerman might have been making some sort of preparations through this money with this other passport that initially wasn't disclosed, that perhaps he was thinking about taking off.
That's a huge point to make, Bob. The fact that this judge believes that it's even possible that Mr. Zimmerman might abscond is the entire reason that this bond amount is the way it is. Mr. Zimmerman has to assure the court he's going to be back in court on a charge that he could get life in prison for. And this judge has now found that he may leave. Even though he heard no evidence of it, he didn't hear any evidence he wasn't leaving, and those lies have really affected the way he thinks.
Jeff Dean, thanks so much. We'll be talking with you throughout the afternoon. Mark O'Mara told me that if the bond was set at $1 million, it would, in his words, devastate the defense fund, and they would have to think long and hard about putting up that amount of money to get George Zimmerman out of jail for a second time. Reporting live outside the Seminole County Courthouse, I'm Bob Keeling, West 2 News.